arrested for simply protesting. Well, and you are saying, let us give them power to regulate social media. I would never be part of that.
Inebe, there was something you said earlier when you referred to the Eastern Security Network. I hope you are not justifying violence by any group inside Nigeria, because one of the bases for the objection of the federal government to Twitter is that Twitter has become a platform inside Nigeria for a particular separatist movement within the country. And then you were, you know, waxing lyrical about the Eastern Security Network, the ESN, the militant wing of the IPOB. If you could just clarify your position on that before we move on.
I totally oppose. I totally deprecate and condemn unreservedly the killing of policemen, the burning of police stations, the carnage that is going on in the East. I am not sympathetic to IPOP. I don't believe in IPOP. I don't subscribe to IPOP. I am not a follower of Nnamdi Kanu. I have never been. I have always been critical of what he's fighting for. I do not believe in Biafra. I also do not believe in splitting Nigeria, even though I totally oppose the fraudulent one Nigeria they are talking about, because the united Nigeria that I want must be based on justice, must be based on rule of law. But I do not believe that we should divide the country. At the same time, we cannot criminalize what ordinarily should be an exercise of the right to self-determination. Eastern Security Network, whatever they are doing, I do not endorse it. I totally condemn it. But the point I am making, Dr. Bhatti, is that we should not be addressing these matters on the surface. Let us go to the roots. What led to the Eastern Security Network? Did Nnamdi Kanu just start with this group? They started by marching, carrying flag, going on the street, protesting. What was the response of the Nigerian state? What was the response of the Buhari regime? They deployed Operation Python Dance. The Python was dancing on the lives of the people of the Saudis. People were being killed. People were being slaughtered. They were being attacked. They were not even allowed to protest, even when they charged him for treasonable felony. Even when they had filed charges before Justice Nyako at the Federal High Court in Abuja, the military, in a so-called democracy, invaded the house of Nnamdi Kanu, desecrated the palace of his father, who was a traditional ruler. You cannot have that in a decent country. So as we condemn the killing of policemen, the burning of police, the burn of stations and INEC offices, we must admit that this regime, this government, takes responsibility for the resort to violence by the group known as Eastern Security Network. If we are not truthful about these things, Dr. Bhatti, we will continue to see history repeat itself. Boko Haram started when Muhammad Yusuf was extrajudicially killed. Have we learned any lesson as a country? The answer is no. We are still resorting to primitive, draconian ways of responding to civic agitation. When people are protesting, you engage them, you talk to them. That is why you say you are running a democracy. You don't kill them. You don't deny them of the right to protest. But we keep saying IPOP, IPOP, and what the president said, he will speak to them in the language that they understand. These people have not recovered, the people of Eastern Nigeria, the Igbos in particular. They are still going through the agony of the civil war. And you are saying you treat them the language they understand? What is the language of the civil war?
But there's an argument, and I like your comments on that argument, that the president's remarks were taken out of context. Those he was referring to were the armed groups who have forgotten the pains of the Southeast during the Civil War. The armed groups who are going around torching Nigerian infrastructure belongs to us, INEC infrastructure, for our democracy. That comment was made to a specific cadre of criminals. So those who leapt to their defense were wrong-footed, including Twitter, who did not take time to appreciate the broader context of that remark before deleting the tweet. Now, should Twitter have approached the Nigerian government, because this is a sovereign state, before deleting that tweet? I want you to, I want your take on that. And also the general global move towards social media regulation. The US government, the US House of Representatives actually has four bills right now in the offing to restrain social media giants about utilizing user data, buying other platforms. I grant you, none of them is trying to restrain or censor the actual posts that individuals make. But there is a general sense that social media giants are too big for their britches. Your comments.
Do you know that as I speak today, Nigeria does not have a data protection law, embarrassingly enough. Because you are citing the example, and that is why I'm saying, when we make these comparisons, we must look at the peculiarity of these countries. There is no single one data protection law in Nigeria today, not even one. Not even one that protects the data of Nigerians. We don't have. We do not have. Now, you make, you know, the point that the president's coming was taken out of context. The only person or persons who took the president's coming out of context is the president and Lai Mohammed. Nigerians understood what he said. I personally understood what he said. The context in which he said it was clear. He didn't just stop at that. He didn't say he was referring to the armed groups. No. When you look at it objectively, when you look at it in context, because he said that they have businesses all over the country. Is it IPOB that has businesses all over the country? Does IPOB have business in Kano, in Sokoto, in Zamfara, in Benue, in Kwara, in Ogun, in Cross River? They don't. Does Eastern Security Network have businesses all over the country? The answer is no. Buhari was referring to the Igbos. We can admit it. We can pretend about it. His body language has been clear. He started by saying you cannot treat 93 and 5% equally. We have seen how he has marginalized the Igbos. No Igbo is represented in the National Security Council. Look at the nepotism. So when we are saying his comment was taken out of context, are we also saying that his nepotistic appointments, his clearly sectional appointments are also taken out of context? Because this is a president that has a pedigree, a shameful pedigree, an unfortunate pedigree of favoring a section of the country that has polarized this country as never before. So that is not a president that you will tell me spoke at, that people are taking him out of context. He was clear on what he meant. In any event, we have had the so-called herdsmen or the so-called armed Fulani herdsmen committing killing people across the country from the north to the south. Has he spoken to them? Because in your interview with him, he made reference to what Governor Otom said, that the Governor Otom said is Fulani and that he cannot deny it. Not all Fulanis are criminals. But has Buhari spoken to his kinsmen, the ones that are criminals, the ones that are armed, in the language that they understand? The answer is no. With what language have they been speaking to them? Language of encouragement, language of endorsement, ruga, settlement, grazing roads, and so on and so forth. Despite that governors have rejected these divisive policies, Buhari is still trying to force it on the throat of Nigerians. He has not addressed the killings by the herdsmen. Has he spoken to bandits in the language that they understand for the last 6 years? The answer is no. Rather, Gumi is advocating amnesty. School students are being kidnapped. Just yesterday, people were praying in Zaria against kidnapping. Buhari has not spoken to kidnappers in the northeast, the northwest, in the language that they understand. He has also not spoken to Boko Haram and ISWAP in the language that they understand. But suddenly, he now knows the language that IPOB will understand. I do not think that is how to run a country whose unity you are willing to kill for. I do not think how to run a country that is...
Anyway, let's move on from this Twitter and this political